Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But, just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, "The next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross." And, from my time at the post office, "Please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs, special schools, special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.